Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.
Track one, Resurrection, produced by No ID. I guess I'll go first. 7-.
Oh my God, the Mel 7-. Jesse, can you believe what's going on over here?
Don't make me start debunking narratives tonight, okay? I thought we were past this. The Mel 7- is as valid as anyone else's.
No, okay? That's not a good rating for the song.
Kicking off one of the most classic albums of all time. Classic intro with a 7. Just so we're clear here. Recent example, by the way. Nail Tech by Jack Harlow. You enjoy that?
Yes, I enjoy Nail Tech more than Resurrection by Common. Yes.
Brother, okay. We know about you.
I give this a flat 9. Dang me, baby. It's tied for.
Oh wow.
Okay. It's tied with like 3 other songs for favorite song on the album. God, it's amazing.
I'm losing in the bracket already. I give it also a flat 9.
Okay. Well. You guys love it. I mean, what do you want me to do?
Yeah, we love it.
What is there not to love?
That's a loaded question. Okay, like I don't have to love
a 7. A 7- is like,
yeah, it's like I barely like it.
Like what kept you? Why a minus? Did you not like the rapping? Did you not like the beat? What was it?
Well, okay, let me get into it. All right, so let's start with the lyrics. Jesse should appreciate that. So I'm not saying this is bad. It's just kind of nothing to me. This is very lyrical miracle. He starts out. Over the global, my vocals be traveling, unraveling my abdomen. It's slime that's babbling, grammatics that are masculine. It's like, okay, all right. Now, of course, this does not happen the whole album. It's just the first track. But it's like, all right, what is that really? Like, what is that supposed to do for me? You know? Like, and I'll say this. His flow, his delivery is kind of dizzying, okay? There's lots of wordplay on here.
I think in a good way.
You know what it is, though?
This is what I miss from him. This is what he doesn't do anymore.
Well, dizzying can work. It can also be a little disorienting. This was a lot to take in for me personally. Coming off of 50 Cent, Will Smith, and Playboi Carti, this is kind of like, whoa, you know, like, slow down, kid. Work a hold a little bit, you know? And I get more acquainted as it goes. But of course, I ran the album back and back. This one, despite repeated listens, still felt like it was a blur. Like it was like a flurry of lines. And it's like, let some of them, you know, let them let them rest. Like, say the line, take a beat, you know, let it settle in, and then continue, you know? Now, for some people, that style works. Okay? I mean, we know about me, right? Like, I'm the Twista hater, supposedly. It could be argued that Mel doesn't. You don't have to rap like this. You know,
you're the Chicago hater.
Doesn't have. I'm not the Chicago hater. I can't be when I like Lupe as much as I do. You don't have to rap like molasses, you know. But like, it's just, it's a lot. You know, it's a lot. So that style of rapping doesn't go as far with me as it might other people. Okay, there's that. The beat isn't nearly one of my favorites, and I'm not saying it's bad. It's not a bad beat. It's a good beat, but I like other beats on this album much more. About the beat, in fact, when it comes on for a split second, it sounds like that other guy who Common referenced in that soundbite we played, who made him kind of, I guess, step his game up. You know, the man with the classic 5-track album, Illmatic, you know? The second this comes on, it sounds like The World Is Yours for like a split second. Just a split second. Am I alone in that? In hearing that?
You're alone in that.
Really?
Yes. It's just scratching. No.
No. It's like the little jazzy keys. Like, I'm not gonna say you guys are gaslighting me because it's a pretty.
They're,
you know,
two,
like,
different tones. The keys on Resurrection are much lighter than the World Is Yours keys.
Look.
The World Is Yours is boom, boom, boom.
That part just like the do, like it reminds me of that.
Are you talking about the bass line?
Yeah, I guess so. Like this.
That's a bass line. That's not keys.
You hear the keys. And ding, 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 but this.
That's
not the world is yours.
It kind of reminds me of that.
No. Those are two different keys.
No, this is right here. I'll play it from the phone. This is.
Hold on, fiance style.
Wait,
fiance what? Style. Hold on.
We're recording.
Hello.
I'm going to bed.
All right. Have a good night. Quick question. You think Common's a good rapper?
I don't know.
She doesn't know. Okay, that's what we're discussing tonight. All right, have a good night.
Oh,
love
my
you.
Goodness.
Later.
Jesse's fiance is massively over for me, personally. She's great.
She's the most over character on the show right now.
I mean, like, all right, it's fine. And maybe I'm the only person who hears it. That's okay. That's all right.
No, that Ahmad Jamad sample with the piano is amazing. And I just want to say, whoever... Ahmad Jamal... Ooh.
Oh, okay. Because that's my main man, Ahmad Rashad.
But, you don't know about him.
NBA inside.
I know. Oh my God. Did he just say, I don't know about Ahmad Rashad?
No, I said, NBA we don't know about him.
Oh, you don't? Yes, you do. You know about him. You got to know about him.
I don't know about him. Never
play
heard.
Play football with OJ. NBA inside stuff.
He ain't moves ain't 90s, but okay.
Have you seen their daughter?
No.
You haven't seen Condola Rashad?
No. Nah.
That's a good looking woman.
I'm on a cleanse.
I mean, she has good looking parents, huh?
Said I'm on a cleanse right now. I haven't really been.
She's not porn. She's just an attractive.
I know,
black
but
woman.
Like any like, I don't want to see no women when I'm on a cleanse. Like, it's just...
she's not like she doesn't. She's not in bikinis or anything. She's just an actress.
Okay.
Anyway, attractive woman.
Yeah. Look, I like the record. Okay.
The scratching though, I don't know who's doing it on the whole album. This is some of the best scratching I've ever heard in my life.
Okay.
Well, you cannot say that the scratching. You cannot say that the scratching isn't like some elite level turntablism that you're hearing all throughout this album. We've heard a lot of scratching already on this show, and rarely is it as artfully done and as smooth as it sounds on here. It makes a lot of the songs for me, and enhances a lot of the beats.
Okay. I mean. Maybe it's just me, because whenever we've done album with scratching, I've noticed it, but like the best thing scratching can do for me is not get in the way. And it rarely does, but like I've heard some sloppy scratching, and it kind of takes
me out of
it.
Yeah, there's sloppy, out of time
the
scratching.
The best thing scratching can do is not get in the way?
Yeah, I mean, it can enhance things, but like a lot of times it just like it's a nice garnish. Like, it's never like, man, this, you know what this needs? Like,
Mel
some scratching.
No, this is the most. This is maybe the most Meliant Rap statement I've ever heard
fine.
In my life.
I'll own it. But, like, when have you ever heard a song and been like, this needs some scratching?
Not needs,
ten,
but like,
ten,
holy
ten
shit.
Crack commandments.
But here's the thing, though. Are you just used to it like that? Because you wouldn't know unless you heard it without scratching.
Well, I think you're a victim of growing up in an era where they took scratching out of pretty much every rap record.
Right. Like, scratching used to be like the highlight of
some
songs.
And you didn't really spend much of your, youth, like, going back and listening to these classic albums.
Look, I like scratching. Don't get me wrong. I've never thought of it as a necessary element to add to a song to make it whole, is what I'm saying. Like,
Mel, have you heard Latifah's Had It Up There by Queen Latifah?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, man. Number one, it's a classic song, but if the scratching at the end of that doesn't make you a fan of scratching...
No, I mean, look, here's the thing. There are plenty of times where I'm like, yo, the scratching was dope. But there's never been a time in my life...
You didn't think on this album at any point, wow, they're really going crazy with the scratching all over this album.
I don't really like think of this as like a scratching album. No, that wasn't a part of the album that really jumped out to me. Like,
can you play the song again?
Sure. Yeah.
Play the end of this, Mel.
The end of what?
End of the record when it's all beat juggling and stuff and scratching.
Oh, when it like the pump fake where it acts like it's gonna fade out and comes back.
Yes.
Okay. Well, I mean, I would have to play the whole song. Are we doing that?
Well, you just play it from your phone or something.
All right. Let me just
scratching is an important element of this album. I don't know who did it, if it was Why Not or if it was No ID, but It's the maybe the best scratching I've ever heard on a rap record.
No, I wouldn't go that far, but
let me see. I'm trying to pull it up right now. Common Resurrection.
Oh, I had a joke I was going to pull out. It may be too early, but yeah.
Let me see.
You're teetering on a joke, Moles.
At Domino's, you can carry out
oh, God.
Pizzas for $5.99 each, as well as lava cakes, bread bites, and more. A good thing you bundled your home auto.
And lava cakes are a four, by the way.
And you get round-the-clock protection.
Okay, let's see.
Skip they don't taste good to me. They're too rich.
They're not. They're not good. Okay, hold on. It's fading out. I mean, that's good scratching. I never said it was bad. It's just like, I guess for me, it wasn't a defining character. Like, when I think about this album, I don't really think about the scratching, you know?
But a lot of the records have, like, scratched choruses in lieu of actual choruses. There's those moments at the end where they let the beat ride out and they're scratching. I think it's pretty prominently featured throughout.
Yeah, I mean, maybe it's just like you said, me being of a different generation, perhaps that's I take scratching for granted.
Like, you know? I remember when Back Then came out by Mike Jones, and rap nerds were freaking out about the fact that it had a scratch chorus.
Back then, they didn't want me. Now I'm high, hold all on me. Yeah, okay, I mean.
Because there was actual scratching in there, right?
Right.
And it was weird, but, like, the hip-hop heads actually liked Swisha House because they did a lot of scratching.
Hold on, where's the drop? Oh my god, and that's all it took, just a little bit of scratching, and then now they're Swisha House fans.
Yes.
All right, here it is.
You fucking Mark.
Okay, all right, I know how to get them next time. All right, all I gotta do is start putting
Moles all night. You keep talking about Blue and Exile, and fucking if you find some way to shoehorn Kendrick into this conversation, we're going to use that against you too. Okay,
I'm just happy Kendrick I figured out how to get the Dusties on my side. All right, I'm gonna start doing all my reviews use like this. Okay. And they got away.
Yo, what about Devin the Dude who does all that scratching with his mouth like you just did? Like, you don't notice that? You don't like that?
Oh no, I've definitely noticed that. Like, and no, I must remind you, I don't dislike it. I'm just saying, like, it didn't, like, pop out to me as, like, one of the things that I think about when I think
about it. Well, I guess I'm scratchy, then. Confirmed.
Oh. Right. Okay, I'm itchy. And you're scratchy. There we go. All right. Yeah.
Resurrection. Jesse, what do you think of this one?
Oh, that was Mr. Sinister from The Executioners, I guess.
That's who's doing the scratching?
Yeah. The Executioners are fucking dope. I know all about them. They work with them Linkin Park boys. I've been knowing about the Executioners forever.
Okay.
Yep.
They're fucking scratching. The Executioners are fucking insane at scratching. Yo, I literally love you guys. Right here, right now. I didn't know you were the ones behind it. You know who I thought it might have been, Jesse? DJ Dummy. But he was young. He might have been too young.
This is a blind DJ?
Kind no, he's not blind. DJ Dummy wasn't blind, was he?
No, maybe I'm thinking about the other guy. Common had a blind DJ at some point.
Nah, DJ Dummy was touring with him, like, during the B era, because that's when I saw him live. And that dude was amazing. He wasn't blind, but he was amazing.
Okay.
My bad. I was thinking about somebody else. There's a blind DJ.
How would you be able to, because that's like a sight...
No, you put Braille on the record labels, like on the front of the records.
Well, right, but you would need to cue up the things and, like, know where to place the needles and
stuff.
Well,
yeah, you should get Braille, like, I don't know, like raised sort of printed stickers to put on the front labels, right? And you, like, feel it and you're like, "Oh, this is Aretha Franklin." I'm taking it out.
Well, yeah, you wouldn't know, I guess, what you're picking up, but, like, you would still need to place the needle on specific parts of, and you can't put Braille on the actual, like, part of the record that plays.
Maybe you got in. Well, maybe that's what makes him a fucking legend
right?
Figured it out. Oh, you know what? You feel the grooves of the record with your finger. You're like, "Oh, okay, here's the drop it. Boom, done." And then you're already in the other side of your headphones. They can't hear it, but you're queuing it up, you can get it ready.
Right, right.
You can spin it back a little bit, like, wait, this isn't where I need to be. Boom, there we go.
Shout out to all my blind DJs.
I'm not saying it's easy to DJ blind. I think that's a... I think that that's a level of feral joy I could never potentially achieve.
Feral joy. Shout out to Maggie Rogers.
Shout out to I'm thinking of DJ Touchtone from Philly. Best of love to the blind community, but there's a lot of blind DJs.
Wow. Okay, well, listen, look.
Like, I Google imaged blind DJs. There's a lot of them.
Despite y'all affliction, you are seen.
Yes, and you know what? When we say triple B's, well, we didn't say it, but you know, on the intro with LeVar Ball, when he says triple, triple B's blind. And double R, he's talking about blind bad bitches.
There you go.
Better than blind black bitches, but that's a...
wait.
It's a Brandy
who
Rose.
Who told you it was open mic night, bitch?
Oh, God. Okay. Yeah, Jesse, you were going to tell us how you feel about this.
Oh, I said I had to put my nostalgia to the side to review this album. The drums are super hard on some Tropical Quest shit. I'm Nestle when it's crunch time is not a good line to me.
That line sticks out to me as one of the cheesier lines on this song. I agree.
Right. Mel, do you get, or Mules, do you get if poetry is pussy, I be sunshine?
I was wondering about that. Is there like a character in a movie named like Sunshine something?
Yeah, Harlem Nights.
Got it.
I guess Melane Rap pop quiz number one. I'm hyped like I'm unsigned. Do you get
unsigned
it?
Unsigned hype. Come on, man. Don't do me like that.
What does that mean?
That's the column in the daggone.
He knows.
Source.
In the daggone. Go ahead.
The source.
Got it. All right. I guess ding yourself. that's probably gonna be the only one you pass tonight.
No, we'll see. We'll see about that.
I asked no for his ID, and the judge thought it was two of me. Like, what the fuck does that mean?
Well, that whole sequence, I called it Testify the Prequel. Because he was like, I bonded with the break and had enough to make bail. A misdemeanor fell on his knees for the jury. I asked no for his ID,
and
the judge thought there was two of me. Motion for a recess to retest my fingerprints. They relinquished since because I was guilty.
Because I was guilty of the sense.
A lot of courtroom wordplay and... Like I said, it was. I'm not sure what that line means exactly, Jesse.
Exactly. The man's name is Dion, but no ID. I asked no for his ID, and they just thought it was two of me. Like, what the fuck?
Maybe like they're brothers. Like they're so like tight that like he's like another me. Maybe like.
And the judge thought it was two of me.
No. Well, I mean, yeah. No, because he didn't drop the sense from common. They relinquished sense because I was guilty in a sense.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make it work.
That's a play
like,
on the
maybe in storyline, like Sense was locked up and Common was let free, and that's why the Sense was dropped in the future.
That's a play on the word innocence, guilty.
Well,
innocence.
I know that. Yeah, I know that.
Right, but yeah.
With all these critiques, though, why a 9 still? Why not alter your rating at this point?
I just said to you, there are Nori songs that I give a 9, but Nori's not really rapping.
I mean, if you enjoy what you're listening to, regardless of the criticisms, then it is what it is. It's a 9 for you.
Yeah, it's a 9.
Now, I will say this. I know I say it like Lyrical Miracle. There's an instance on here where I think the Lyrical Miracle works. When he's like, start a verse to, I ride the rhythm like a swim bike. When in dim light, I use insight to enlight. Devices hit the skin tight. Words of wisdom well from my windpipe. Imagination's in flight. I send light like Ben Sky. That was dope. I mean, it made sense to me.
It opened like on gym night.
You never, I mean, that's not bad. It's just like, it's, at worst, it's a filler bar, you know? Like, I wouldn't say that's bad.
I think when he's going, doing this sort of rapidy rap thing,
it's more so focused on the flow, right?
Like, yeah, it's focused on the flow. I'm not really concerned about even if any of this shit makes sense. He just sounds good doing it, as far as I'm concerned.
Got it. Yeah, I mean,
like Jesse's pointing out some bars, and I'm like, yeah, these aren't good bars from like a. If you read them, you're like, okay, this isn't clever.
Yeah, out of context, really but like you have to hear them rapped to you, and see what Common was going for. Obviously,
and
it's
you
a
have
part
to hear the beat and the beat. I mean, I'm with Jesse on this one. This is just an amazing beat, beautiful.
He's never been good.
I guess I'm going to hit this, although there are multiple instances on this album, actually, where I'm going to have to hit this, but...
Time to play the game!
I don't think there are multiple.
No, there are. There are.
I think like some two, of them like are might more. Be slang that I just don't get.
One is slang for cigarettes when we get to it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, no, here's the thing, though. I definitely don't think he was talking about cigarettes there, but we'll get there. He said, I spend nights up in redacted. Just think about what rhymes with nights. Which technically isn't homophobic. It's not Triple H about homophobia, but
it's a slur. I mean, it can be considered a slur.
Yeah.
If you say it in a demeaning way.
Sure.
Kamo said of this song in the Check the Technique book by Brian Coleman that Resurrection was one of those two singles off the album. I really felt like I was being born again to people who weren't familiar with me. I felt like I was coming up from the dead of not being heard. And damn. No ID says, I think that was the second single. The video for that one was black and white with some projects in there and gang signs. It was definitely the first time that some of the grittier parts of Chicago culture were put into visuals like that. So Jesse hit me to the fact that the video version of Resurrection actually has a different first verse than the album version. So I brought in the video version here at Jesse's suggestion. So if you want to play a little bit of that, here the first verse.
Because maybe there's a less, rapidy.
It is less wordy, but it's not as free flowing.
Less piano keys too.
Okay. Here's the video version.
Yeah, I'ma get this one off of 87th Street, south side of Chicago. Chicago everywhere, check it. It's like, come on, y'all, get live, get down. Common sense is in your town. I said, come on, y'all, get live, get down. Common sense is in your town. I stagger in the gathering, possessed by a pattern that be scattering. Over the global, my vocals be traveling, unraveling. My abdomen is line is babbling. Grammatics that are masculine, I grab the men. Verbally badgering broads, I wish them Madeline. Was back on video LP. Raps I make up like blacks do excuses. I feel like Noah. Look at my mellas up on uses. If a broad ain't got a mind, a job, a crib, she useless. Acoustic bass lines embrace rhymes while I chase mines. They say signs of the end is near. I wonder, can I walk a righteous path? Hold it up here. Got more verses than a Kramer. Go off like a page. Skills uglier than Craig Mack in your ear. I'm the flavor. My old bird said some of my songs sound like noise. Don't watch the bulls as much. They got too many white boys. A million black men walking towards one direction. For sure, the cream of the planet. Resurrection.
That line is crazy. So basically, as soon as Jordan retired, it was just like, fuck the bulls.
Yes.
Don't watch him as much.
Yeah, as much. I mean, what did they still have John Paxson? I mean, he OG. I don't know if they had Bill Winnings. I mean, this ain't Chicago Bulls rankings, but that line was funny.
There's also the Extra P remix of Resurrection, which I'll be honest, I'm not a big fan of, but some people prefer it to the original.
We know about them, the P pushers. Any chance to add some more P, they're going crazy.
Mel, right. You're disrespecting like one of the greatest producers.
I'm not disrespecting him. It's who's a extra joke.
P? Who's Extra P, Mel?
I don't know.
Exactly. Mel ain't rap.
Well, I ain't rap, but he's not being disrespected. Okay. Extra P, wherever you are, keep peeing. All right. I ain't got no problem with your
You're disrespecting an absolute legend.
I'm not disrespecting him.
By incorporating pushing P into. Yeah.
He'll be fine. He'll be okay. All right.
He's a legend.
Okay. Well, here's the Resurrection remix by the legend Extra P.
I'm gonna get this one off for Chicago, the south side, the west side. Come on, y'all, get live, get down. Common sense is in your town. I said, come on, y'all, get live, get down. Common sense, you know. I stagger in the gathering, possessed by a pattern that be scattering. Over the global, my vocals be traveling, unraveling. My abdomen is line is babbling. Grammatics that are masculine. I grab the men, verbally badgering broads. I wish them Adeline. Was
back on video LP. Raps I make up like blacks do excuses. I feel like Noah, look at my mellows up producers. If abroad ain't got a mind, a job, but grips are useless. Acoustic bass lines and brace rhymes while I chase mines. They say signs of the end is near. I'm a dick and I walk a righteous path holding a beer. My verses that are Kramer go off like a page of skills. Uglier than Craig Mack in your ear, I'm the flavor.
While we're on the topic, Moles, what does I do a show get extra P's like the Large Professor? What does that mean?
Extra P.
Extra, he said extra P's. But what does that mean, pussy?
Oh,
I do a show get extra P.
Extra P's, extra paper?
Maybe extra, you know, extra pounds. Maybe they're doing shows over in the UK with all of our mates.
Yeah. Yeah, common. Okay. Oh, I had a low hanging fruit joke based off of what you were talking about earlier. What does Zane Lowe say when he gets arrested?
What?
Officer or something, balls bocce.
Yeah, come on, dead. Officer. You've seen my ball, you know, low hanging fruit style.
Yeah.
Anyway.
We got one more piece of archival audio, and then we can get our final thoughts in before we move on. It is Knowledge from Kids in the Hall. This man has rapped over three different instrumentals from this album. I take it he's a fan. He's from Chicago. This is the first of three freestyles you'll hear.
He's coming back up soon.
What do you mean?
Part of my archival.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
me too. A lot of knowledge on this one. Shout out to Knowledge.
Knowledge. So, this is not the beat knowledge. Maker Knowledge. This is...
No, not Knowledge with a K. This is Knowledge, N-A-L-E-D-G-E.
Right. From Kids in the Hall. You don't know Kids in the Hall, Mel?
I can't say I do. I know Kids Next Door.
You ain't blog era.
I'm definitely not. I'm
good.
Yeah,
they weren't that important, but they were semi-important.
Okay.
Briefly.
I know kids these days. I know them.
We don't know
them. What the hell is that?
Jesse, you know them?
That was like Vic Mensa's thing, right?
Wasn't he Save Money?
Well, yeah, Save Money Collective, but he was in a band called Kids These Days. That was like a part of Save Money, I guess.
Yeah, you know that, but you don't know Scratching.
Well, it was him, that boy, Nico Segal. Anyway, all right.
Nico Segal, but you don't know Large Professor.
I do know Large Professor.
He's extra P, Mel.
Extra P.
No, he's not. Wait, what?
He's not? Okay, Mel ain't right.
Wait.
No, so he's not.
No, wait, hold on. So Large Professor is extra P.
Don't worry about it, Mel.
Well, how was I supposed to know that?
Dude, as a self-respecting rap fan, okay.
So look, it's like, what scientist. Is it? Is it like an alter ego? Is it a nickname?
It's a nickname. Just look up a song called The Mad Scientist. I'm called The Mad Scientist Extra P. That's the first line of the song.
All right. Well, I'm sorry. I do know Large Professor, though.
You don't know Extra P.
Why didn't he call the Large Professor remix?
You're a racist. That ain't P.
All right. Here's this freestyle from Knowledge with an N.
Yeah. You don't stop. Call me Mr. Go Ill, Mr. So Real. Spit with the feel of an ecstasy pill in a lambskin condom. So down to earth, but I speak like a Martian. Caution, out of this world with the flow. If beats were a holding, this what it sounds like when knowledge make love. Midnight rendezvous with the vocal booth, eargasmic. Bury MCs like the hatchet. Perhaps it's just my God-given demeanor that I find it easy. Stay on my toes like ballerina. Disciple of the dreamer, quicker than Serena. Bar so special that I'm call him Neutrogena. Get the picture better than a chick from Wilhelmina. Life is a bitch. Have you seen her? Have you seen her? Fuck her with a Trojan like the field in Pasadena. Paid in full hustler. Cherry red beamer. Lord of the underground. Hit your town. Take your crown. Turn it upside down like symbol of underground. Sound of the profound. Mind toss now like Sabathia on mound. Get the picture. Imitate Karl Lagerfeld. In my eyes, y'all small. Paris dog, Tinkerbell. Give them hell. Give them hell to the beat screen.
Sounds good to me.
Not to me, but whatever.
Okay. What would you rate that, Jesse?
Just based on what 6 heard. Minus.
It's like oh, 7. Wow. Yeah. Like no higher than a 7.
Okay.
I think it proves that Common is more than Jesse's giving him credit for.
Damn, you brought that boy in just to bury him, Wolf?
I brought him in because it's relevant. Someone rapped on the beat. Okay. I don't have to like it. It's part of history, though.
Oh, man. All right.
I had another question, Mel. Back to that slur conversation. Is it a slur if
a woman who is like bisexual.
Well, you're asking the wrong person. I don't think it's for me to say. It would be for.
So, do you think it's like the N-word where it's like they can say it?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Okay, because so, like Azealia Banks says it a lot.
Right. And I mean, and we you it's the Cakes to Kill a quit. We're this for the redacted. You
oh
know?
Man, that's a 10.
Okay. Yeah.
Nella's a colleague of Mr. Killer.
I performed with him. Well, not with him, but like same bill as him once. I technically
I don't know
opened
about him.
For
is he
him.
Gay?
What's that?
I don't know anything about him. Is he gay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Did you think he was just saying that?
When you have 2 second clips, they could do anything. Have you guys heard of Mickey Blanco?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I'm like cool with. I know. I'm not trying to be funny. Is it like a her or like it? Is,
nah,
is,
I don't know.
Is she sure. trans or? I'm cool with Mickey Blanco's brother. That's all. I'm gonna say his or her.
Okay.
Mickey Blanco's brother is a very talented artist in his own right. So,
Mickey Blanco is very talented, I think.
And not my kind of music, but you know we can move on. Mickey Blanco's music is definitely Cakes to Kill a drop, and we can move on.
We don't have the drop, so Jesse's protected there.
Mickey Blanco.
I'm not lying.
Mickey Blanco may be a better rapper than Common after the year 2000.
I can't comment because I've never heard Mickey Blanco. So, but that just that's
Azealia
funny...
Banks is the GOAT of that movement.
Agreed. Agreed. We'll be doing her shortly, soon, ish. Next year.
Okay. Well. Only other things I really have to say are there's a special ed reference that I did catch. Mel is rap when he went do 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 do. I know that's a bass line from I Got It Made. I think you say Common doesn't have quotables. I quite enjoyed I Baited.
Hey Jesse,
lines.
Nothing. No, you didn't pop for Mel getting the do 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 do.
No, because that's come up on the show before.
Fair enough. I bathe in bass lines, rinse and ribs, dry and drums, come from a tribe of bums, hooked on Negro and mums. I mean, I thought that's, I guess, it's, you know, it's dope rapping, dope writing. I think a quotable of the song, I'm a hoe, but not a hoe nigga. Okay. You know, like, I mean, there are things here. I mean, he's talked about it in the soundbite, but you know, cruise the South Side streets with no heat and no sticker. It's vivid, you know, to use that word that's overused. Yeah, I mean, like, look, you ask why 7-minus, it's not one of my favorite beats on here. It's a little disorienting to me, you know, but you'll see why in comparison to other tracks on the album, why I have to go as low as a 7-minus. So yeah, man, I like it. Okay, people. All right, y'all, I like it.
Mr. 7-minus, we know about you on these classic albums, right, Jesse?
We know about him.
Is there anything else that you two would like to say about the record?
I have nothing at the moment.
Okay.
I've exhausted my thoughts on this one. We can move on.
Oh, I'm sorry. There was one more thing. When the song fades and then comes back, am I being a head ass or do you think that was intentional because like the song's being resurrected?
You're overthinking it.
Okay, so I was a head ass. All right.
They just wanted to create a pop for the listeners.
Got it. All right.
You gotta love when he leaves and comes back.
Yeah, I was like, oh, is that supposed to be like a literal resurrection of the song? You know, like, okay. All right. Well, we moving on.
Genius Mel in the building.
I was just running it by you. I'm just floating it, you know? Because unlike lesser human beings, I wouldn't run to Genius and try to pass it off as fact, you know? Like, the song fades out and returns because it's meant to emulate resurrection. Like, no, it was just a thought. Okay, so we can move on. Track 2, I
we
used to love
down.
It.
We can get down. You know?
What song was that? That was a...
Don't worry about it, Mel.
No, we did that before on the show, right?
Yeah.
What song was that?
A Tribe Called Quest, man.
There we go, okay. All right, here we go. Right.
Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by RapRankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.